The countdown to Election Day is on, and Fox 8 is taking you front and center in the race for U.S. Senate. Republican J.D. Vance.
Now we've got to convince voters all across the state of Ohio, whether they're Republicans or Democrats or in between, that I'm the guy to represent them, and I think we're going to do that.
He's facing off against Democrat Tim Ryan.
Democrat, Republican, Independent, if you're like tired of the fights, want to find some points of agreement that we can move forward, reform, I'm your guy.
Monday, October 10th at 7 o'clock. The two candidates meeting face-to-face for the first time here in the Fox 8 studio for a statewide debate airing on Nexstar stations across Ohio. And new numbers show it's a tight race. The latest Fox 8 Emerson College The Hill poll has Vance with a slight lead over Tim Ryan, 44-40, with 13% of voters that haven't made up their mind yet. But taken all together and considering the margin of error, the poll's director says Vance and Ryan are neck and neck.
And it's very important as everybody's watching these polls is to read them properly. So that 44% can be as high as 47. It could be as low as 41. And that 40% could be as high as 43. So this poll, statistically speaking, shows a dead heat with Ryan and Vance.
And this debate will be the first time these candidates can face off about issues that matter to voters. According to our poll, first and foremost, it's the economy.
The big thing, and there are a lot of things that we need to fix, the big problem, the big self-inflicted wound is energy. So you see it when you fill up your car, but if you're an Ohio farmer, you see it when you buy fertilizer. If you're an Ohio trucker, you see it when you buy diesel. All of the energy inputs into our economy, everything has gotten more expensive because we don't have enough of our homegrown energy. And this is not an act of God. This is not something that fell upon us that Joe Biden had no control over. We decided to try to destroy America's energy economy in an effort to transition to a green economy. But what it's made us do is rely on the Chinese for our fossil fuels and fossil fuel related industries. It's hurt Ohio workers. It hasn't made our environment any cleaner. It's just been a failure across the board, and we need to undo those policies.
What are we doing moving forward? I'm calling for a massive tax cut for working class people and small businesses who have gotten hammered through this whole thing. I'm calling for us to bring these supply chains back so that we're actually making stuff in the United States. This isn't new to me. I've been talking about this for 20 years. We've let everything go to China, and we got to bring it back here to places like Ohio, and that includes the supply chain so we don't have this problem. And we've got to start making stuff here again in the United States. So that's more of the big picture. But right now it's about a tax cut. And you look at this, like the Intel project, you look at Lordstown Motors and Foxconn, and there's a lot of good things happening, which is why I got to leave the age of stupidity and move on. But right now, tax cut for small businesses, tax cut for workers. Put some money in their pockets.
And abortion.
The abortion debate that we all have in this country, and I recognize there are very intense views on both sides of the issue, it should be a political debate, not a legal debate. In other words, the Supreme Court should not determine that you can have an abortion up to 25 or 40 weeks or whatever the number is that we're going to decide as a political society. We should debate that issue, right? And I'm pro-life. I recognize I'm going to be on the other side of a lot of people, even a lot of people who I hope to earn their vote. But at the end of the day, that is a debate that should be for the people, for their elected representatives.
And it was amazing to think after 50 years of this being a right for a woman that our 18-year-old daughter has now lost that right. And to me, it's like the largest government overreach in the history of our lifetime. If you're like against big government, this is big government in your bedroom, in your doctor's office. And here's the thing for Ohio, because Ohio's laws are so extreme, no exceptions for rape or incest or any of that, terrible for business. How are we gonna recruit good businesses who are thriving, we want them to move to Ohio? Intel, electric cars, electric trucks, solar, like the industries of the future. They're not going to want to be in a state where they can't recruit young workers or people who want to start a family and are going to be scared to death that if there's a complexity to the pregnancy, that they could potentially go to prison or their doctor could go to prison. So this is big government and terrible for business.
No shortage of issues or disagreements for the candidates to debate. Again, the Fox 8 News Nexstar debate with J.D. Vance and Tim Ryan airs this Monday at 7 p.m. Joe Tuohy, Fox 8 News.